Thank you so much for joining us for this interview.
Sure.
If you don't mind, could you just share with us what was the creative process like for when you were composing pieces for Aham?
I have to say that five years was the one who was coming with the concept. He and his brother, Akhilesh, and that Shyam, thanks for ideas. It was like they were telling me what they wanted. And I was just reacting to it. So as they kept on telling me how it developed, the music also developed. And during the process, I asked them what would be the size of the orchestra and who would be the players. So accordingly, I had to choose, like, depending on the instruments they're going to use. I had to also give them their respective roles. So it flowered like a place.
Okay.
Yeah, in all, I think 5-6 pieces were there. And each one was different. At times I thought it was complicated, but that's how it figured out.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, sir, you've worked with many orchestras before and many productions.
Yeah.
So, how do you feel about SIFAS Alumni and our orchestra?
SIFAS has got its own name and fame. What I want to, because Sai Vignesh is a accomplished singer by himself, and his brother is also a member of the guest, and most of the players whom he introduced, they were all budding talent, and I'm really impressed with their dedication, I would say. So I used to check with him whether this is all right, this section is possible to be performed, or do we have to change? And he would say, no, sir, we can manage.
Yeah.
They would all take it up seriously. That's what I found, because when I first came in March, March, I think I came for the first round of rehearsals. They had just picked up, and Vignesh had taken the trouble of putting everything into proper notation. And from then to now, they have really worked hard. And I think that dedication is very important. That's because they are not full-time professionals and they are away from full-time music.
Yeah.
Yet that fire is there. So that's something to appreciate really.
So glad to hear that from you,
sir. Sure, sure.
So now you might be aware that Singapore is celebrating 50 years of independence.
Yeah, yeah.
So how do you think over the past few years Indian arts has grown in Singapore?
I don't find much difference between India and Singapore as far as the arts can be said. Because I can say a lot of the plays of the Indian music there. Because many people have come and settled from there. And it is not a faraway place from India, and they have always been in touch with Indian music. So, and even I have come here as a performer, and I have watched people, both the Singapore Indians, working with non-Indians. There is something common in Asian music, where in general.
Yeah.
So in that way, I think Indian arts, Indian music is very common and popular in Singapore. And over the years, it has only brought us together. And it can be described as the soul of the world music, I would say. And Chinese music is very famous, pentatonic scale is very famous. There are musicians coming together, so people coming together, cultures coming together, harmony. This is what I would describe. So much has been said about Aham. So please come and watch Aham on India.